to this week's Spotlight Assembly. Today's Spotlight is hosted by myself, Ezra, and also Roki.
As we continue to learn online, it's really important to look after our own health and well-being. Last week, we talked about taking responsibility for looking after our health by going to bed on time and also finding ways to keep active. Mixing socially with old friends or making new friends is also important for our well-being. Make sure that you try to join the after-school social club on a Thursday and Mr. Joe's Get Active Club on a Tuesday. We all have certain things we like to do to relax and take care of ourselves. Let's hear from Jamie this week to see what she recommends.
What calms my brain? I think yoga is a very healthy thing to do and very eco-friendly because it helps yourself and your brain because it calms you and it helps you exercise more. Reading. I think reading is a good thing for your brain because it teaches you more words and you don't need to look at the screen. Playing on my Nintendo Switch. There's one particular game that actually helps your brain. Dr. Kawashima's Brain Training by Jamie.
Thinking of looking after our physical well-being, we have a very special announcement from our director of sports, Mr. Cho, who is going to share an exciting challenge.
Hi guys, my name is Joe Rodway. I'm the new director of sport here at Nexus International School. I'm excited today to be able to tell you about a virtual event that we are hosting here at Nexus, starting on the 20th of September and going on for 3 weeks. It's called KL's Fittest. It's an online virtual fitness competition for under 11s, under 13s and under 15s, both boys and girls. It's a fitness competition where all of the workouts are going to be completed in the safety of your own home with no equipment required apart from a plastic pole or a broomstick or something similar to that. All right. So far, we've got 8 schools signed up from all around KL and one from JB. All right. Now, further details are going to be coming out to you guys on Monday with everything you need to know regarding how to train for it, how to get yourself prepared and how to enter. Okay, so I look forward to seeing as many people representing Nexus International School in KL's Fittest and seeing if you guys can get yourself through to the final and represent us in the KL International School scene.
This Tuesday, we all enjoyed a public holiday called Merdeka Day. Let's hear more about this important day from our learners.
Do you know why we had a public holiday on Tuesday?
It was Merdeka Day.
What is Merdeka?
It is Independence Day.
What does Independence Day mean to you, Emery and Iman?
It means living in harmony and peace.
To me, it means freedom and unity.
Do you know what happened in 1956?
In 1956, the late led a group of people to London to have a round table with the British. I wonder what it's all about.
The meeting was about Federation of Malaya, wanting to be independent.
The late Tunku signed the agreement with the British.
Oh, so the date of the first independence for the Federation of Malaya, now known as Malaysia, was on the 31st August 1957.
Well, upon arriving in Malaya, the late Tunku went to Bandar Hilir in Malacca to announce the date of Independence Day.
I wonder why.
Malacca was the first state in which foreign invasions had begun, way before the British arrived.
First, it was the Portuguese.
It was the Dutch.
After that, it was the British in Malaya.
Next, it was the Japanese.
Finally, it was the British.
Now I understand the red, blue and white in our Jalo Gumilang represent of the Commonwealth countries.
The color dark blue also represent unity.
The yellow represent royalty.
The red represent bravery.
The white represents purity.
Crescent and star represents the official religion in Malaysia.
There are 13 states, and Kuala Lumpur, Putrajaya, and Labuan are known as one federal territory.
That is represented by the 14-point star in the Jalo Gumilang. It is known as Bintang Persekutuan Star in Bahasa Melayu.
The late Tunku Abdul Rahman was our first Prime Minister?
Yes, the late Tunku was known as the father of independence. On the 31st August 1957, Malaya's first Prime Minister, the late Tunku Abdul Rahman, shouted Merdeka!
Merdeka!
Sometimes at the Merdeka Stadium, Kuala Lumpur.
This year, the slogan for Hari Merdeka is Malaysia Prihatin, which means Malaysia cares.
Merdeka, Merdeka.
I feel really grateful.
Malaysia gained independence 64 years ago on August 31st, 1957. It was a great day for Malaysia and will be remembered for millennia to come. It is also a day that we remember our freedom fighters and thank them for what they did all those years ago. I hope we remember what it is to be a Malaysian and how to help our society. I also hope that after COVID, we will all be able to come together and celebrate Merdeka in a grand way.
So how I feel about Malaysia is, I feel like, since I'm Malaysian, I feel like I am a part of it.
I'm actually feeling pretty proud because it is our 64th year of independence, and like I'm really proud of how we got this far, and like our country didn't go down in any way. COVID doesn't, anyway. My other feelings are, I feel really grateful that they let different nationalities into Malaysia so that many people like me can be mixed, so we're not just Malaysian, we can be Indian and Malaysia mixed, we can be Chinese and Malaysian, we could be all sorts. So yeah, that's my opinion on Merdeka Day. So, bye!
The meaning of independence for me is freedom, joy, and harmony.
Spotlight on Talent. This week, Hala has shared a video of her playing a musical instrument called the kalimba. After the video, we will see what learning has been going on throughout the school.
Hi, I'm Hala, and today I will be playing a song called Bluebird on an instrument called the kalimba. Let's start.
Thank you.
That's it for me. I hope you enjoyed it. Bye.
Growled overhead. Zelda stared into the darkness. Wind lashed the glistening tarmac, and streetlights flickered on and off, casting long shadows. Rusted dustbins rattled, fence creaked, and rain drummed on car roofs. Zelda shivered. Where could she escape? Thunder growled overhead as Zelda crouched in the darkness. Wind went along the glistening tarmac and streetlights flickered, casting long shadows along the pavement. Rusted bins rattled and fences creaked. Rain drummed over cars, and Zelda shivered. Where could she escape from downpour? At that moment, Zelda sensed something creeping, hugging to the shadows. The quiet figure slipped towards the doorway. Zelda caught a glimpse of a green eye. She heard a growl as the rain danced, causing a thousand deaths onto the pavement. Zelda's fur prickled as she tensed herself. Who was that? At that moment, Zelda ducked under a proton and found some space under an engine. It was still warm. The mysterious rain cat came back again with its jutted teeth and its scarlet mouth. Zelda felt a power surge. She flinched. Zelda saw the rain cat coming closer and nearer. Then suddenly, she could see his green eyes menacingly, and could hear his sharp claws coming closer to the car. Then suddenly, he stopped and smelled.
How could he smell Zelda's fear?
To Ian in year 3 and Erham in year 6.
Thank you so much to our incredible presenters, Rochi and Ezra. What naturals you were. Well done. I really enjoyed listening to you. And I hope everybody's had a fantastic week of learning. I hope that you've all been rigorous and you are submitting all of your work within the lessons, unless your teacher has told you otherwise. Remember, do your best, keep that progress coming, okay? I'm very excited about KL's fittest challenge, Mr. Joe's challenge that he shared with you. I hope that you're all excited about hearing more on Monday, and I hope that we'll have so many representatives from Nexus joining in the challenge, okay? Remember, part of our personal goal, being kind to ourselves, to our minds and our bodies, is all about looking after our fitness levels, okay? And staying active. Now, I hope also, thinking about being kind to ourselves, our minds and our bodies, you've been joining in the social groups after school on a Thursday, because that's a really important way to connect with your friends. And next week we will start our newspaper reporting club, which is open to year 5 and year 6 learners. If you joined last year, you might want to join again, but we're open for new people joining. I'm going to talk you through the amazing site that Aditya has created all on his own. He designed it, he created it, he's added the work to it. And I'll be sharing this with teachers so that they can share it with learners to have a read of the work that our group did last year. Okay, so I'll talk you through the site now. Okay, so this is the fantastic new site, Nexus new site, created, designed, totally built by Aditya, who is in year 6. And he has collated all of the work of the news group and put it on these tabs. Now, if you scroll down, and I'll share this site with all your teachers so they can share it with you. We have Spotlight on Learning Assembly there, LinkedIn. And if we go to the news report section, you click on news around the world, and we've got stories about COVID around the world. If you would like to join the news reporting club, which will start this next Thursday at 3:30 till 4 p.m. So you can join the social clubs first and then join the news club. You can let your teachers know or myself know, walla.c@nexus.edu.my by Wednesday. And it's just taken a little while to load. I'll scroll down just so you can see that you can choose what you would like to focus on as a reporter. So we'll talk about what is included in a newspaper. You might want to be an investigative journalist. You might want to report on news stories around the world in Malaysia. You might want to focus on the fun side and add some jokes and riddles. I'll just go back to this. So some of our learners chose to create jokes and riddles pages with nice illustrations, and you can have a look through there. And some of our learners wanted to show their artistic side and create stories through comics, and they chose how they wanted to record those. So some sketched them on paper and some did them on the computer. Okay, so if you would like to be involved in the newspaper club, please let your teacher know or let me know by next Wednesday, and we will see you online next Thursday. I'll share the Meet link codes with your teachers before next Thursday. Okay, have a wonderful weekend, and we'll see you next week for another great week of learning.